What's up, guys? Ian here, Coach of your Lightning Lantern, bringing you guys our playoff quarterfinals team builder here for Season 8 Substrika. Very happy that we did end up winning our last week there against Amish and pushing ourselves through to playoffs by ourselves. I believe we finished in 7th. We finished in the 7th seed. This is actually the third game of playoffs. Two of them happened before mine. So Mike got upset by Nacho. That was seed number 2 versus seed number 6. And Stu beat Amish. And that was seed number 5 versus seed number 8. Unfortunately for me, Mike and Amish were actually the only two people in playoffs that I had defeated in the regular season. So all five of the other people that are still in playoffs, I did not beat in the regular season. Which I think bodes at least a little bit poorly for me. You know, sometimes it's better to be on the losing end of things, and I think it might help in this one a little bit, but sometimes the matchups are just like bad enough that you couldn't have overcome that anyway. So as I'm recording this the night before, I'm supposed to play Lux in the morning, but I'm not gonna have enough time to film the team builder and deal with it and also like make breakfast and stuff. So if I sound a little bit tired, that's because I am. It's like almost midnight and I'm just trying to get this done. But Lux's team has not changed since last time, so if you watched our week 7 team builder, it's the exact same team here as it was back then. Kieran Black, Suicune, Ribombee, Alolan Muk, Colossal, Palossand, Mega Gallade, Zapdos, Skarmory, Oddno, and Charjabug. Priority in the Muk with Shadow Sneak and the Gallade with Shadow Sneak. He brought both last time, but I don't know if they had Shadow Sneak on them. Hazard sitting in the Ribombee with Webs, Colossal with Rocks and Spikes, Palossand with Rocks, Skarm with Rocks and Spikes, and Charjabug with Webs. He did not bring the Skarm or the Charjabug last time, or the Palossand. He only had the Colossal for Hazards, and it just set them up and then exploded on my Gardevoir, but I ended up defogging them away later. Removal options, he's got the Ribombee with Defog, Colossal with Rapid Spin, Zapdos with Defog, and Skarmory with Defog. I don't really expect him to bring a removal, to be completely honest with you. There's really no point in it for him. He can just bring boots on a bunch of stuff and not bother with removal against my team. So while I'm listing it there, it's really just for your purposes and not for mine. Four times weaknesses, just the Colossal to Water and Ground. Water against this team is actually really potent. His water resists are Kieran Black and Suicune. Unfortunately, I can't really punish that because my water type is Rotom Wash, but if I had like a Greninja or something, Surf Spam would actually be really broken against this team, I think. But or like physical water, you know what I mean? Like Azumarill, just like clicking Liquidation over and over and over again. I'm honestly just anticipating him to bring like the same team. I am not really sure what he would change up. Like, he had the Alolan Muk, obviously, as a Dragapult check, right? Colossal was obviously there for, I mean, I guess as a Rude in theory, but in reality, it was probably the Abomasnow. I did bring a Scarf Abomasnow, and he does also have access to my videos, so he can watch and see what I brought last time. I swapped out Abomasnow for Luxray, and we'll get to that in a sec, but I don't really anticipate a change, even though I thought that he could have brought pretty much anything. I do think that Oddno probably stays on the back burner. He's probably not that scared of Dragapult with an Alolan Muk. And realistically, he probably shouldn't be, but this Dragapult set can definitely deal with that. So shoutouts to Jay for this Dragapult set. He just built this. As soon as he saw the matchup, he built this set for me, and I'm like, all right, well, I'm going to build in like a week. But I just pasted it in, and we're going to explain it here. So this whole season, I have just completely forgot that gems were allowed. And there have usually been better items, but for the most part, gem is actually really good on Dragapult. So Fire Gem on Dragapult here with Fire Blast is able to kill the Skarmory. I think it's Spidef Skarmory or something after Sturdy is broken. So if he does bring the Skarmory, then I have that. Otherwise, just a powered up Fire Blast and something else should be able to actually dent stuff, considering I'm physically offensive. Dragon Dance, Dragon Earth, and Phantom Force is the main bread and butter of this set, outspeeding the Ribombee. Excuse me, I didn't want to get too fancy with it. I could have done like a weird creep where I was like creeping Ribombee, creeping Persian, or I could have just crept like max speed Gallade, even though he's not going to be max speed Gallade. Things of that nature that I could have done, but I didn't. I am running Naive. This is less weak to the Shadow Sneakers and the Muk and the Gallade, but Dragon Darts is just OP. I've shown that all season, and Hopefully I'll be able to show it off here. If I can get a Drain Dance off, then I'm outspeeding the Scarf Zapdos that was such a terror in the late game against me last time. And maybe he can just miss moves. That's also a good option. Yeah, the special attack investment, like I said, is there for the Skarmory, so a little bit of bulk on there afterwards. Nidoqueen, I'm bringing an offensive Nidoqueen because I actually think it just goes absolutely ham against this team. I actually just don't see switching to offensive Nidoqueen on his team. For the most part, I would imagine it's the Palossand. Palossand is just going to get absolutely rocked by Ice Beam, so Nidoqueen is kind of just going to dick on him. I've got Earth Power, Thunderbolt, Stealth Rock, and Ice Beam. There's really no other move that I need in this one. Earth Power is going to be able to demolish the Colossal and the Alolan Muk, and it's my best move against the Kieran Black. And then, I'm not saying against Kieran Black, by the way. Thunderbolt is there mainly just for the Skarmory, but also for this weekend. Excuse me, Earth Power for the Glade if I was staying in on that, which I'm also probably not staying in on. And Ice Beam for the Palossand, so I might not end up clicking Ice Beam, but it's also there for the Zapdos. So, decent coverage here. And the Rocks, like I said, I don't expect him to bring removal, but the Rocks might be able to punish something. Or like break a Surtee on the Skarmory, right? Which is all important for the Dragapult. So, I do have the Rocks there just in case he's not running boots on stuff. Gardevoir, this is identical. This is the same Gardevoir set that I brought last time. I misplayed around the Colossal last time, and I'm not going to make that same mistake. And Gardevoir can go ham. This Gardevoir set is really good against him. It's really strong against him, I think. Like I said before, in the last Heat Builder, the Destiny Bond really pressures him to either give me a kill or give me another, or give me damage. So I really like the idea of keeping Destiny Bond, and a combo of Hyper Voice and Thunderbolt hits this whole team neutrally or super effectively. So I like that as well, going with myself here. Thunderbolt, again, it's just for the Skarmory. I might be overprepping for the Skarmory, but I'd rather have prep for it if it does come than no prep. My prep against the Zapdos is obviously kind of poor, but we'll sort of see where that goes. I am speed tying Zapdos. Nidoqueen. Excuse me. Nidoqueen is just max speed because I want to throw him off. He likes aggressively creeping. So if he's gonna like aggressively creep my like Buzzwole or something with like Suicune, or he's creeping Nidoqueen creeping like Skarmory or something like that, then I'm gonna catch him off guard by running this much speed. So Luxray, fully specially defensive. This is my Zapdos answer. So the Scarf Zapdos shouldn't be able to dent this if it's going to be that sort of set again. If it's not, then I'm more prepared. But I'm minus special attack. Anyways, Volt Switch Toxic, Player of Spark. This is should be okay. Spark is the same as Thunderfang, except I get a Paralysis chance, and Paralysis against some of these ones really, really useful. Especially if it's like Kieran Black trying to switch into my Electric type moves. I do have Player Off for that, but Spark Paralysis into Player Off would be kind of useful. And Intimidate will help against the Muk and the Kieran Black. Obviously, I can't intimidate the Glade because of its ability, which is really shitty, but what can you do? Heatran. I'm bringing Shookaberry Heatran. This is the same set, actually. I don't think I changed this Heatran set at all. It's still the same Shookaberry Heatran for Earthquake, Earthquake Glade. I don't know that he would want Earthquake, but worst case, I can maybe get a Flame Body Burn. it's also there as a Shooka for Earth Power Kieran Black, which he fell into last time, and I Flash Cannoned him in the face. Oh my god, pardon me. Back to yawning Ian, but it is late, and I'm just trying to get this out. But yeah, Toxic for the Suicune, mostly. Scorching Sands for Colossal, and also potentially hit the Muk, and then Flash Cannon Lava Plume hit everything else really well. Just getting status. The whole idea last time was just to spread status, but I'm also fine with just like spreading whatever status I can this game anyways. Last time I was bringing it for Hex Dragapult, but this time it's just there for the purpose of spreading it, and being able to burn like a Glade and stuff like that is really useful. Rotomwash, same thing. It's the same exact Rotomwash set. So I've really just imported the Heatran, Rotomwash, and Gardevoir sets entirely. I like completely copied them from last time because I don't think there's anything wrong with them, to be honest. But it's a physically defensive Rotomwash to handle the main Glade. Should be able to handle it pretty okay, at least early on until it gets a Swords Dance up. And after it gets a Swords Dance up, if it's got Shadow Sneak, I'd probably just lose the game. But that's just going to be something we're having to live with. If I'm being completely honest, I don't think we stand a chance anyway, so it doesn't really matter to me. I'm not being, like, pessimistic or anything like that. It's just my all-time record against Lux is not good, and he just always seems to understand how to build against me, which is just incredibly tilting. There's a few people who are like that, and it's just like, I don't want to fucking play you. Because it's annoying to play people like that when they just always have my number. Because it's no fun. It's no fun for me. So, anywho, that is going to be it for that. Zarude, I'm not bringing because of the Zapdos. And the Kirin Black, it's pretty much fodder for Kirin Black, Zapdos, and Gallade, which... all of which he brought last time, and also the Rubambi. But yeah, Alolan Persian, I don't remember why I didn't bring it last time, but it's pretty garbage in this matchup, I think. There's been a lot of matchups where it's usable. This one, I don't think it's usable, just because I needed to do something more than just, like, be a pivot, you know? I need to do something more than that. Kecleon could be okay, but it's also pretty bad against Gallade overall. Sorry, Buzzwool I was considering, and I dropped last second, actually. I had it over... what did I have it over? I think I had it over Luxray, and I was like, I need something for the Zapdos, because I'm just going to get dicked down by Scarf Zapdos again. So I wanted to throw Luxray on there as a defensive electric. Abomasnow I brought last time as a Scarf set. Really could have done fine again in a rematch, but that sort of set was kind of niche enough that it doesn't really work past the first time, so I'm not bringing it. And that's pretty much it. Yeah, Buzzwool's like the big one that definitely could have come to this one, but I left on the bench because I just don't think that it's worthwhile to bring. So that is going to be for me. Hopefully you guys enjoyed, and sorry about the yawning, but I will catch you guys for our match tomorrow.